Okay, let's take this very last look at the null space, at least for now. Two things I want to get from this, just do some three more examples and then get one level of deeper understanding of what is going on here. I have this 2x5 matrix here and it's all zeros. And so that has got to equal the zero vector. On this hand side, I'm asking, what is the null space of this? Well, remember, I need a linear combination of this column plus a linear combination of that, linear combination, linear combination. So some scalar times this, some scalar times that, some scalar times this, some. So there better be 5 of these, x2, x3, x4, and x5. So that better give me, I better have 5 there so that I could get to this side. And think of it, I can multiply anything by 0, 0, and I add to that anything multiplied by 0, 0, plus anything times 0, 0, plus anything. So I'm actually, my null space is the whole of R5. There better be 5 things there. And my null space, I can think about just this linear combination of the columns of the identity matrix. So there's 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. And I have 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. And I have 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. And 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Any linear combination of the C1 plus C2 plus C3 plus C4 plus C5, and that is going to give me, any this C1, C2, C3, C4, and C5, and that can take on any value. C1 to C5 is 5 scalars that can take any value, and what we can see is each of these being a kind of special case. And it's just linear combinations of each of these. And in this instance, you might write here as well as x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, just to end up there with x1, x2. So the point being is it can take any real value, leaving me with the null space of being this. But look at this. There are actually 5 special cases here. Why is there 5 special cases? Because, I have 5 things that I can change. Just remember that for now. So I have these 5 special cases. A linear combination of this will give me the full null space, which is the full of this 5 space. If I were to do elementary row operations on this, I'm going to end up with this. And in essence, this is saying x1 equals minus 2 times x2. Because it's x1 plus 2 times x2 equals 0. I'm taking the minus x2 over to the other side. So as soon as I fix this, this can be anything at once. As soon as I choose it, x1 becomes fixed. So let's choose 1 that fixes the x1. And so that is the special case. The whole of the null space will be a scalar multiple of that. And in R2, that is going to be minus 2 plus 1 is going to be this line in R2. And my null space is anywhere, my complete null space is on anywhere on that line, and that is my one special case. Why is there one special case? This is 0, 0 here, nothing to help us there. But here is 1 is free, and then immediately the other one is fixed. Therefore, one special case. Let's do this one. If I were to do this one, I'm going to get to, so that's just twice 2 of those. I'm going to get this. So what's happening here? I'm saying x1 equals minus twice x2 minus x3 minus twice x4. So how many special cases am I going to get? I'm going to get 3 special cases, because 3 of these can vary and at any one time, and it immediately fixes the other one. I can let these 3 roam 3, and then immediately it fixes this one. So I can let this equal 1 and the other 2 zeros. That means this one is negative 2, so a special solution. I can let this be a 0, and this be a 1, and that be a 0. And that gives me a minus 1 there. There's my second special case. And I can have a 0 and a 0 and a 1 there. It fixes that one to minus 2. There's my 3 cases. Why 3 special solutions? Because 3 of these could roam 3, fixing the other one. And now it's just a linear combination of these to give me the full null space. So it's going to be this, again, this hyperplane in R4 is going to be the null space of this matrix of coefficients. Remember this one from before? It had two special cases. Why would there be two? Because, you know, I have 1, 2, 3 that can, you know, that can roam, that can sort of roam free. But if you think about it, this is a zero, and these two are linked here, that x3 equals minus x4. That takes away one of the possible three that we had, and that is going to give us this, the fact that there's only two. So you've learned something new by doing new examples, but one deeper level of understanding is figuring out how many special cases you are going to get given your matrix of coefficients, and how to lead from that to normal examples, how to do a linear combination of those to give us the total null space of our matrix of coefficients that we were given. So that's it for null spaces.